Repop is trying to fix the whole New York Comic Con debacle, and I got a bone to pick. Let's talk about it.
Welcome to the Gas and Cats. I'm glad you passed by. You get the right time. We got an all-time high. Bubbles, hot toys, and chimes on mine. Stick around, like, comment, and be sure to subscribe. Because life's a little better when you answer Chris and Evan. Hey, life's a little better when you answer Chris and Evan. Hey, life's a little better when you answer Chris and Evan. And remember, at these hallowed walls, we hunt together. Yes.
What do you mean you got a bone to pick? Is that code for something else?
That's code for my wampa. You would understand that joke if you watched yesterday's video. So if you haven't, go back and watch that, and then come back to this video and then watch this one, and you'll totally get that inside joke. When I say wampa, I mean my So I want to talk about the whole Reed Pop debacle and this whole New York Comic Con fiasco. And I also want to talk about a situation that I'm not real happy about. But first, make sure you hit the subscribe button and the little bell. That way you'll know anytime we go live or post new content. We post new content every day. And we go live between 8 and 9 p.m. on Sundays. Oh, and it's Eastern time for all of you people not in the Eastern time zone. Also, hit the like button because that actually helps our reach so more people will be able to see this video and watch more of the Gasolcast.
All right, so New York Comic Con posted a statement saying that reservations will go back up tomorrow, which is Thursday, September 29th at 1 p.m. Eastern. Why are they putting them back up? Well, because everything was f***ed up on Monday when they actually went up.
Oh, God. That was a f***ing mess.
It really was.
And on the post today, they said it's going to go a lot smoother.
Yeah, I don't think it will.
Smooth like a diarrhea.
I mean, honestly, that is pretty, like, easy to get out.
It is really easy to get out. It's evacuating your system. It just comes right out of there.
Well, so maybe we'll be able to go right in there.
What are you putting in after your diarrhea? What's that? What are you talking about?
I'm talking about that you compared it to diarrhea.
Yeah, but it's coming out, and you're sure you're going back in.
Like, I'm not going back into the butthole, Chris. Going into the reservations. To address two things that I mentioned in our video when we posted that the New York reservations were going live. First thing I said was that they would go live Monday the 29th. I was half true, and I'm also f***ing psychic because Monday was the 26th and they went live, but Thursday is the 29th and they're going live again.
Holy sh**.
What's up, bitch? Second of all, I also up really bad in the video where I said you could get one reservation for exclusives each day, but that was wrong. That was very wrong. You can only get
Whoa, you're telling me you're wrong?
Yeah, I just skimmed through the blog post.
I mean, this never happens. I try to tell you you're wrong sometimes when I know you're wrong, but you tell me for sure that you're right.
You didn't tell me I was wrong.
I'm just saying.
So you were wrong too. You are allowed one exhibitor exclusive reservation per weekend. That's it. Unless you have a VIP pass, then you get two. I don't even know, like, what exhibitors you have to reserve for aside from Funko, because Loungefly isn't on that list, and I use them as an example just because it was an easy example to use.
So you were wrong about that also?
I use it as an example.
Oh my God, that video is a mess!
Yeah, it's a f***ing mess.
Alright, so now New York Comic Con and Repop, they're gonna try to do things better. And guess what? It's gonna be a mess! I'm not looking forward to this. It's going to be horrible. I already know it's going to be bad. Now, they are having you sign into your account to make your reservation this time instead of just going cowboy. That might actually help.
It might, but still. I mean, there are so many people going to New York Comic Con. It's unreal.
Yeah, this is not going to end well, and I'm not looking forward to tomorrow at all. But make sure if you're going to New York Comic Con that you're on the website, you're signed in, you're ready to go. That way, you can get all the reservations squared away, like Funko, because I think that's probably the most important one on the list. I read an article today where it talked about the whole situation that happened this week with the reservations, and they specifically mentioned Funko in the article.
Wow.
Because it's so popular, because so many people are upset about it. Basically, it was just going over all the events that occurred on Monday. It must be ugly if they have to write an article about it. You know what I mean?
Like, yeah.
All right, so fingers crossed. Hold on.
I'm crossing all 10 of my toes, too.
I'm crossing something else. Like a pretzel.
Look at me.
Oh, I gotta do both of these.
No, you gotta do the thumbs too.
Having a hard time keeping this one tucked down here. So good luck to you.
Hey, you might be wondering why we are in different shirts. Well, that's because we just recorded an interview with our friend Chris, and we decided to dress in Mischief Toys shirts because it was a Gazzlecast Mischief Toys interview, and something crazy just happened.
Reservations just popped up for New York Comic Con,
and we just got our Funko booth reservations.
Crazy, right?
Never expected for this to happen. It sort of just happened at random. Somebody sent us the link. We clicked into it. We had to sign into our account just as New York Comic Con stated. We got in, we got out, and we got the reservation for Funko booth. This is the very first time ever in my Funko career that this has happened. We're also going to a Funko event, Fright Night. We're gonna have our own booth at New York Comic Con. There's just so much to be excited about.
Real quick, what time did you get your reservation for?
10:30 a.m. I don't want to talk about that.
Yeah, so he got his reservation for 30 minutes after the convention opens, when we will be selling our Mischief Toys products.
I'm just hoping maybe a friend will help us out and stand in line or something. I don't know.
I'm sure somebody would be willing to take your spot in the Funko booth, especially if you offer them something you don't want, but they want.
Anyway, I'm just excited that we got Funko booth reservations, and you got one, I got one. We're all getting one.
It's like Oprah.
Should we do like an exciting dance? Well, all that dance, it took it right out of me!
Took what right out of you?
My energy.
Oh, yeah, I'm a little tired.
Anyway, here's the rest of the video. Bye!
And the second thing we want to talk about is...
Well, I'm not real happy. Because somebody on social media is crapping on somebody who bought a bunch of Freddy Venoms, and now they're turning them around and selling them for $40,000 a piece.
Okay, it wasn't just one somebody, it was a lot of somebodies.
I don't think this is a bad thing in the Funko community. It was actually made out to be sort of a negative thing, and I think that's absolutely wrong, because if you take a common economics class, this is how life works. Somebody went out and purchased a bunch of the Freddy Venoms when they were a lower cost. There were only 24 of the Freddy Funko Venoms.
And rumor has it, this one person had somewhere between 15 and 18 of the 24 piece pop.
Of course, they had most of them, so they were able to corner the market. And it would be stupid not to drive the price up. This is a Funko Pop that a lot of people want, but most people are not gonna get because the price is way up there. Even when it first released, it was way up there. So this guy was dropping big money in order to buy these Funko Pops, and now he has driven the price up to basically buy yourself, I don't know, what kind of car could you buy? A Kia Sorento.
I personally would not spend that kind of money on a Funko Pop if I had it. However, I see absolutely no issue with this because, like Chris said, that's how things work. What I do see an issue with is going to the store, finding today's hot pop, picking it up, going on Whatnot, and selling it for 4, 5, 6, 7, sometimes 10 times an inflated cost.
People that were on the internet today were saying that what happened with those Freddy Venoms was bad for the community. But let me remind you, people are on Whatnot selling Funko Pops and sodas for a ridiculous amount to you. My friends, you guys are the viewers of a YouTube channel like ours. You don't see us on Whatnot selling off all of our shit to you at 3, 4, maybe 5 times the price. We would never do something like that to our viewers, and we totally wouldn't do that to our friends. And that's what we consider you. We consider you friends. You're our bros.
Bros before hoes.
That's right, bros before hoes. So if you're gonna go out there and you're gonna say that this is bad for the community, what happened with the Freddy Venom is bad for the community, look in the mirror. Whatnot is absolutely horrible. It's a cancer on this community. But I will say, sometimes Whatnot isn't that bad. And that's because there's a lot of charity sort of events that happen through it, and I think those are great. So I'm not talking bad about them, so I don't want you hounding me in the comment section. I don't want you hounding me on Instagram, and I sure as hell don't want you hounding me while I'm at New York Comic Con. We're at booth 3641. I will listen to all of your gripes if you want, but I'm selling Ghastlies. So if you're coming, you're buying a Ghastly!
And you're waiting in line just like everybody else. Not only are there really nice charity events, but you can find good deals on Whatnot. We are specifically talking about people who just buy something today for a really low cost and take advantage of people by selling them for a super duper inflated price.
I'm not even talking about that. I'm talking about people with channels like ours, people who have fans, and they're taking product, putting it up on Whatnot, and they know they can get a lot more money for it above PPG. That is the problem. People that have YouTube channels and other followings like TikTok and Instagram, and they're using their followers. And I understand that you could say that, well, the viewers are spending the money, and of course they are. But who the f*** are we to do that to our viewers? We care about our viewers. And I'm not trying to be noble, and I'm not trying to be a white knight in any way, shape, or form. I'm just saying, this is bull.
It absolutely is, and one person that I saw complaining definitely does take advantage of people, definitely does sell above retail for new pops. Keep in mind, these Freddy Venoms, there's only 24 made. Also, it's an older pop. They didn't pull it off the shelf for $15, and now they're selling it for $40,000.
And you also had to be at a very special event. It was a Fundays Funko Pop. Freddy Funkos from Fundays are Funko Pops that carry a high value, no matter what way you slice it. I think it's wrong to judge somebody who buys 18 of 24 Funko Pops and sells them for a ridiculous amount of money, because at first he had to spend a lot of money on each one of these Funko Pops in order to get the 18 out of the 24 that he had. So the fact that he cornered the market makes absolute sense to me, and he would be stupid if he didn't. What's he supposed to do? Just give them away?
Well, yeah, you should give them away at what would be a retail cost. So $15 is what you should sell them for.
How dare you?
Honestly, though, even if he hadn't cornered the market, it's 24 pieces. So who's to say if naturally over time it wouldn't reach that amount anyway?
He got all the Funko Pops. He wanted to make his Freddy Funko Army, and he did. And now he's making profit off the sales. Again, simple economics class.
And it's definitely not as as flipping.
Flipping on whatnot? The worst thing that's happened to the Funko community since the Funko Pops from Venom 2, Let There Be Carnage.
I know somebody else who cornered a market. It's me. I have probably the biggest collection of Snowman Captain Americas known to mankind.
Get the f*** out of here. What are you gonna do with them? Auction them off on whatnot?
For $40,000.
Oh my god, we're getting a Kia Sorento.
When these pops were first released, you could hardly give them away. They were like $5 to $8. Now, guess what the value of my Snowman caps are?
Oh, shit.
18, and it's all due to me.
Oh my god!
That's my snowman cap graph.
Oh my god.
See, it was way down there?
Oh my god.
And now it's way up here.
Holy sh**.
I'm gonna be rolling in money, baby.
Bring
just like
it right
this.
Here. What's that?
I'm doing my money dance.
I wanna do a high five. But
okay, hold on, let me finish.
You're doing that dance like those little dancing flowers you put in the window? Well, what say you about New York Comic Con and Reed Pop? And also, how about the Freddy Venoms? Do you agree with us or do you agree with the other people? We would love to know. Let us know all that and more in the comment section down below. And do you think Whatnot is terrible for the community at large? I mean, I know there are good things about Whatnot, but overall, it's trash!
Whatnot, the place that you can go to get overpriced Funko Pops and get called a name at the same time. Download the Whatnot app today. Psych. Don't.
Head over to PoppinOffToys.com and buy your Funko Pops, Funko Sodas, and Funko Mystery Minis. They've got it all. PoppinOffToys.com. And don't forget, use our promo code GASSELCAST to get 10% off. They just put up a bunch of new sodas over there, and you might want to buy yourself some. You can buy 6 and get the chase. That's a pretty good deal. PoppinOffToys.com. This is the part of the video where we like to thank our patrons from Patreon. You guys are amazing. And in every video, we like to shout out to 10 of you. So, in this video, we'd like to shout out to Hassan E., Justin and Stacy McKenzie, Kevin Hartke, Stephen Owens, Tyler C., Ryan Guerrero, Shroot Farm Pops, Kaz Brooks, Pablo Perez, and Sean Neal. Thank you guys so much for your continued support. We appreciate all of our patrons. You guys rock. Oh my god, you stayed until the end of the video. That's amazing. Thank you so much. We love you. It actually helps this channel a lot, and we appreciate all of that support. You guys rock. And just as a reminder, we will have Gargoyle Ghastly at NYCC next week. So if you're going to be there, visit us 3641. It's going to be amazing. We have a lot of really cool things to unveil there. So check us out. Go to mischieftoys.com and sign up for our newsletter, because we're dropping our brand new Glow Ghastly this week. Our Error Glow Ghastly. He's awesome.
He will be dropping this coming Friday, September 30th at 3 p.m. Eastern Time. You don't want to miss out.
All right, it's that time again. Remember, as always, we hunt together. Yes, we'll catch you next time.
Bye.